This film is a real life story about this incredible young boy who goes scavenging on a train with his older brother, Gudu. And they get separated from each other.
Gudu? Gudu?
He gets on this train and is hurtled across the entire of India. And he's lost.
As soon as I heard this story, it just did something to me. It sounded emotional, beautiful, a miraculous story. It just connected to me in a way that I just knew I was interested and I was going to do this. It was this instant thing. It was kind of weird. In a broad sense, I saw the first half of the movie, the Indian movie, as an external story. And I saw the second half as an internal story, like a yin and a yang.
You okay?
I'm lost. The project was really a no-brainer for me. I've seen Top of the Lake, Garth's TV show, and I was completely blown away. He's an incredibly grounded filmmaker that's full of, you know, soul and nuance.
Good cut.
Good cut.
Each of the characters were, like, symbolic. They needed to kind of be a world unto themselves.
What if you do find home and they're not even there?
It had to resonate, so I knew I had to find quality actors that could hold that space.
He's very connected, really, to his own spirit and his own way in which he tells stories. And I think you feel that humanity. I mean, you feel that when you're working with him as an actor, but his compassion for the children and his ability to direct those children,
yes,
who were not actors, obviously, and got spectacular performances from them.
Do you have any idea what it's like knowing my real brother and mother spent every day of their lives looking for me?
Oh, I've loved working with Garth. It's been incredible.
Don't you do that.
Don't you dare do that. This is on you, not on me.
You know, he like always calls after a big day to thank you and tell you what a good job you did. And he's just so loving.
I think it's great.
There was something mythical in this story. There was something kind of timeless. It's like an odyssey of sorts. So I just thought, just keep it very simple. It's like a snowball effect. You're starting with this beautiful family, this beautiful boy, and then you just, I mean, you end up in Australia and you end up with this guy finding home on a computer. It's about hope and the power of hope and the power of love.
Every night I imagine that I'm walking those streets home and I know every single step of the way. And I whisper in her ear, I'm here. A lot of my friends who have watched this, the first thing they do is, you know, want to call their parents or their brothers or their sisters or their friends and just, you know, tell them they love them or give someone a warm hug. Because it really is about people and families and relationships at its core. And that's a beautiful, positive message to be putting out to the world at this time.
Hey, Lisa here. So your movie lover? Well, in this day and age, we see hundreds of movies a year in numerous genres like action, comedy, romance, and more. Some of these movies are great and some just don't live up to our expectations. For all you movie lovers out there, here are some interesting facts from movies that you might or might not know. In the movie Carrie, the end of the movie was shot in reverse order, a technique of the film to make scenes look more ghost-like. A close viewing of the film will show cars moving in reverse. What do the 101 Dalmatians and Wendy from Peter Pan have in common? The 102 characters are the only characters in Disney's past to have both of their parents present and alive for the whole course of the movie. Gone with the Wind producers were fined $5,000 for allowing obscenities in the film's dialogue. The offensive and expensive word, damn. One of the films Will Smith is best known for almost didn't happen. The actor didn't want to participate in Men in Black until his wife persuaded him otherwise. In the film Monsters, Inc., Boo has a Woody doll. That's the famous cowboy from Toy Story. Gilderoy Lockhart from Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets was based on a former boyfriend of writer J.K. Rowling. I Know Who Killed Me, starring Lindsay Lohan, has had the most Razzie Awards ever given to a film. Now, the Razzies are awards for the worst in movies. So, did you know any of these facts? Did you find them interesting? Let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you next time.